How cool would it be if you could photosynthesize? No more cooking or grocery shopping. If you got hungry, all you need is some tasty sunlight. It sounds awesome, but it turns out it's not so easy being green. Photosynthesis allows plants to take sunlight and carbon dioxide and turn it into sugar, which they use for food. Oh, and it also makes oxygen, which is good if you like breathing and all. So, sounds simple enough. You sit in the sun and bam, you have a food supply. Let's get into the mechanics of photosynthesis. Chloroplasts are cute little organelles in plant cells that make photosynthesis happen. They contain the molecule chlorophyll, the stuff that makes plants green. More importantly, the chlorophyll captures the sun's energy. Plants are green because chlorophyll is especially good at absorbing blue and red light, while green and yellow light gets reflected back to your eye, which is why they, you know, look green. If humans had to photosynthesize, we need chloroplasts, so we'd be green. Pretty sweet. So you've got your chlorophyll and you're soaking up some rays. But it's not a very efficient process. Estimates vary, but plants only convert about 5 to 9% of the total available energy from the sun's rays. Since photosynthesis is pretty inefficient at converting sunlight into energy, we would need to absorb a ton of light. Plants evolved broad, flat leaves to increase their surface area and to maximize the amount of sun hitting their chloroplasts. So we need leaves. Great, we'll be able to get plenty of sunlight, but now we run into another issue. Our skin, that thick, oily layer of dead skin cells covering our entire body, that needs some adjusting. It prevents carbon dioxide from getting into the cells of our body. We do exhale CO2 as a waste product, but that CO2 is mainly produced around the brain and in muscles. To photosynthesize, we need carbon dioxide near the surface of our skin. And we need a lot more of it than we produce. So our skin needs to be more porous, like 100 times more porous. That would allow plenty of CO2 in for our human photosynthetic needs. Carbon dioxide is crucial in photosynthesis. We won't get too deep into it, but here's roughly how it works. Chlorophyll absorbs sunlight. The sun's energy splits water molecules, knocking electrons into motion through the chloroplast. This kicks off a series of reactions that creates molecules that store energy, the most famous one being ATP. The split water molecules also release the oxygen that we humans need to breathe. Good work, plants. Now the plant pulls in carbon dioxide from the air. Those energy molecules help put carbon dioxide and the hydrogens from the water together in the Calvin cycle, making sugars like glucose, the sweet, sweet sugar that feeds plants. But these sugars wouldn't give us enough energy to get up and move around. Trees use a lot less energy than people. A typical tree consumes around 200 calories a day, while a typical human consumes around 2,000 calories a day, since we need more fuel for our big, needy human brains and for walking around. So we probably wouldn't make enough energy from photosynthesis to power our usual high-energy human activities, unless you count watching Netflix. So for us to photosynthesize, we'd be green, we'd need leaves, we'd have weird porous skin to let CO2 in, and we'd have to lie out in the sun all day and not move much. Okay, that last part doesn't sound too bad. We'd still have to eat food to get the proteins the human body requires, but we'd be good on the sugars and fats. Overall, photosynthesis doesn't really seem to be the way to go for humans, but it does work for some sea slugs and giant clams. These guys eat photosynthesizing algae or bacteria and use their chloroplasts to make sugars for them to use. So why don't humans do that? Well, scientists think it's just not worth it. The energy we would spend to feed and manage photosynthetic symbionts is better spent foraging and taking care of our other biological needs. So just get a salad and marvel at the chemistry that keeps life going. Would you want to photosynthesize? Let us know in the comments. And check out some more plant-filled science while you're here. Thanks for watching.